Good day, viewers. You're welcome to NAS TV Africa Business Segment, where we manifest Africa's greatness. Today, we'll be hosting the managing director of a foremost developer in West Africa, Refuge Construction and Engineering, in person of Mr. Sidi. In a few minutes, you're going to meet with him and he's going to tell us more about himself. But he's a very big fish. Before we could be able to bring him down here, it was a tough one. And we are quite excited to have you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. This is NAS TV Africa, where we manifest Africa's greatness about our resources in terms of both human and natural resources.
That's right.
Are things that we could do to show the world.
Wow.
So as a developer and one of the foremost developers in West Africa and in terms of construction and engineering,
yeah,
the African youth, the Africans would like to meet you in person.
Thank you very much, Mr. Nasru, the coordinator for this program. I would first of all like to congratulate you for this your outfit.
Thank you very much.
And for showcasing businesses of the youth in particular.
Thank you very much.
To the larger world, so that the larger world can tap into what the youth are doing.
Thank you
so
very much.
So I say kudos to that.
Thank you very much.
Yes, you are right. We are developers, and we are now in Ilorin, the Kwara State capital, and we are developing the Ilorin Automodern Market. It's an international market.
Oh.
And the largest in the north central
wow.
of Nigeria.
Wow.
We started that project sometime in 2009, and work really started in 2010.
Wow.
And we have so many things we have done there. Warehouses, double shops, lockups, single shops, lockups. Mm. Then we have open sheds, and then we have some semi-open sheds. You know, that is to say, the dream of the Kwara State government were highly articulated, and that was what was in the plan. I will review the plan from time to time to meet the yearnings and the needs of the people, not only in Kwara State, but those people who are there to trade. Mm. At the same time, we also cater for those people who are coming to buy.
Mm.
You know, a market.
Yeah, you bridge the gap.
You meet the sellers and the traders.
Bring them closer.
They meet together.
Wow.
So that was done. So, and we also have internal network of roads.
Mm.
We have water and what have you. We have light. Let me first of all thank the Kwara State government for making that market a reality.
Mm.
Because it was more or less a white elephant project when we took over. But today, we are smiling.
Mm.
Smiling in the sense that, you know, like youth, when you have a conception and the thing comes to light, then the next thing
you smile.
It's not even the money that is there, but that's your name. Yes, I did that project
very well.
You know, that makes it so. I say thank you, Kwara State government, for giving us the opportunity to showcase what we as youth could do. Having said that, yes, the market has come to stay, and I'm also gladdened to tell you. And to tell the world at large that the market has a multiplier effect, not only on the immediate surroundings, not only in Adewale. You can see our market breathing as far as to Oloje. They are breathing as far as to airports. They are breathing as far as to Garage Offer. Then let me go further. They are breathing in Okiri, in Panada, in Share.
Wow.
They even beyond the states. People come from Oyo State to come and buy our tomatoes here, to come and buy our yams here. People come from Ekiti State, Ondo State, and what have you. So that is to say, the market has really benefited a lot of people, and we thank God for that. If I go memory down, when we started the project, we were working with snakes and other reptiles. It was a bush.
It was too bushy that time.
Bushy. Nothing. But today, if you are not strong enough financially, you can't even get a shop. You can't even get a shop. And we are the close end of delivering to the Kwara State government.
Oh,
so that is
the project is almost so, running up.
Yes.
Wow. And, this kind of monumental project, and in entrepreneurship.
Yeah.
The bigger your vision, the bigger your project, the more the challenges, the more the problems.
Yeah.
And what stands you out as an entrepreneur is how you are able to do it.
Yes, right.
In this on this platform, the people that are looking up to your consulting company, that have seen you people as role model, and they must be wondering. A lot of young people want to go into your kind of business, like developing, but they think that, okay, fine, it's going to be a straitjacket kind of deal. But there must be several challenges that you face along the line. How did you surmount them?
Thank you very much, our coordinator for this program. You see, when you talk about challenges, see, I remember something those days in the secondary school in physics. I don't know if you read physics. See, in physics,
I was an art student though.
Oh, you missed out.
Wow.
The higher you go, the cooler it becomes. But that theory, you know, does not work when it comes to business. The higher you go in business, the more risk,
the hotter
it becomes. Let me put it in quote, it's a bad word English. The riskier it becomes. But people don't know. That's the reason you find out that the so-called big men, in quotes, they don't sleep because of the challenges they are facing. So like this one.
So it doesn't mean that because you are now rich, it's time to sleep anytime you want.
No, it's even worse.
The richer you become,
you can't even get sleep.
The sleepless you become. Wow.
You can't get sleep.
Good one.
You see, like this modern market, let me give you one flashy example, very flash one. There was a time the main supply, the main pipe supplying water to Ilorin metropolis got busted near the market. Before you know it, the market was flooded.
Wow.
So they were calling left and right. So I have to call government, I'll call the chief of staff. They'll get the GM, the general manager for Kwara Waters, and it has to be fixed that night. So, and I have to be there that night.
Wow.
These are the kind of challenges, unexpected. And in a marketplace like that, there will be, I call it side talk and side talk. There will be quarrels because this is traders from different backgrounds, ethnic groups. So definitely there will be a time where they don't understand themselves.
Yeah.
There will be a time where we as developers,
you have to come for conflict management.
And conflict management has to come in. So many things like that. So, but we thank God in all. But the greatest challenges that we really faced and we are still facing, which I will beg your station to please help us beam it as much as possible, is the challenges of people not paying for their shops. You see, my coordinator, I must say this, that a situation where a shop is just 680, and somebody deposited 100,000 since 2010 and he refused to pay the balance.
What?
Are you going to withdraw the letter of allocation you are giving to him? Are you going to take your customer to court? So, and the balance is just there. Meanwhile, you have your staff to pay. Meanwhile, there are some refunds you make to the government. Meanwhile, this is a PPP project. The government has their own percentage you have to give to them. So, with such money, it's just there. They are not servicing it. And they are holding on to the allocation paper. You can't resell the shop to another person. So what happens? It's a big challenge. And we have several of them like that.
Let me come in like this.
Yes.
You're a businessman.
Yeah.
And it's always said that there's no settlement in business.
Yes.
As much as you are looking at the moral angle to this business, that will be fine. They are being your customers since 2010. They paid 100,000 advance payment.
Yeah.
And they are not paying. That means, and you have been giving light.
Yeah.
You are with the pipe busted. You took it upon yourself to fix it.
Yes.
You are not saying that only fix only those that are paid.
No.
You have been doing your part.
Yes.
And they are not fulfilling their own part of obligation. And then in business, I was told, maybe from elementary economics, that was introduced settlement. As much as the moral situation is important, if your settlement is higher, the business will go down.
That's right.
There must be a strategic decision that you have mapped out that will be taken. Because when you say that you are rounding up, are you going to hand over both assets and the liability of those that have not paid? Then who paid for that? How do you make your profit? Then if they don't pay, how are you going to create another economy problem by laying off staff?
Exactly.
If these people do not pay, his company is not at the risk or on the verge of collapsing if some people are not fulfilling their own part of it. So, if you say NAS TV Africa should help you appeal to them to pay, there must be a deliberate decision on your part that you intend to take, so that the people will know that this is a business and this is a serious business. So, what are the things that you intend to do?
I really thank you for this very question.
No.
I think it's 1 million naira question. It's question that swallow other questions.
Mm.
We are talking of profitability.
Mm.
But unfortunately, I must say that the project is a child of circumstances.
Mm.
There was a former developer that abandoned the project.
Mm.
And therefore, the interest of the public waned with that developer. So the first challenge that we had was to rekindle the confidence of buyers to buy into that project.
Wow.
And as a result, we relaxed many things.
Mm.
I wish they capitalized on. You know, we want that market to get filled. So they capitalized on it.
Mm.
I've been on air in some other radio, in some other television. Proud to this one.
To this.
But this one is very important because we are rounding up.
All right. At this structure, like you said earlier, said you have Yoruba, you have people, you have on letter.
Yes.
Imite is part D.
Yes.
Osi pataki. Kede ki to lopolopo awon to ni shop na lo wa lori online and the people kini ma jade sita
ben
lo si online e so killing we gan e pe
seri be se ni ka ti wa ka be si so ide wa bayi inu medu seri de yan ba ti so ide gesin ngba to le se gesin
abi we awon customer ta wi gesin ko
bo gesin
kini
ji la man so lo ani ede wa ti oja ta ngo Chori kuri tata de Tony kiko ku nyodo abenko
yes
Chori
o se wazaki
ati fe cheton
un
kometa lo wa nle ti a fe ki awon ni bara wa mo adupe wo lowo Olorun lo to igba ta bere odun abere pelu covid corona gbogbo e baun isele lo tun isele lo si ṣùgbọ́n a ṣe alhamdulillah a sì dúpẹ́ lọ́lọ́run pé gbogbo àwọn èèyàn wa lọ́jà wa kò sẹ́ni tí kòró mú kò sẹ́ni tí ó fara pa ọpẹ́ ní fọ́lọ́ ṣùgbọ́n ní ìsìn àwa ti ṣetán láti lọ tọ́ gẹ́gẹ́ bí ẹ ṣe sọ léde gẹ̀ẹ́sì ṣe rí ẹni tí ò bá sanwó ẹ pé o ìkíní kò ní ṣọ́ọ̀bù o
kò jẹ́ tí ò bá sanwó ẹ pé kò ní ṣọ́ọ̀bù wọ́n gbọ́
ìyẹn ìkíní ẹni tó bá tiẹ̀ wá sanwó ẹ̀ pé tí ò sanwó lọ́ọ̀yà deed of assignment wípé ṣọ́ọ̀bù yóò wọ́n ti assign yẹ fún 99 years ẹni náà ní ṣọ́ọ̀bù
tọ̀ ó ti sanwó pé kò sanwó agreement láàrin òun àti lọ́ọ̀yà pé ìwọ ló ní lọ́gọ́rùn ọdún kan dín ọgọ́rùn sísì ó ò ní ṣọ́ọ̀bù
káṣá pé ní ọgọ́rùn ọdún
wọ́n ń gbọ́
ṣókẹ́tẹ̀ bá èyí tó tún wá wà ń bẹ̀ àwọn kan wọn sanwó wọn nígbà rìsíìtì when ya won bo wa gba oja ni won sa lo kini kankan hey
aba
ti le fi kini to joba lowo pem bayi
eyin lo state mi
a lo nu
e lo state mi lati lo sise
a lo bo mi nu
to
we o si beere nkan meta yi to iwe to fi ra iso yi da
isi ti da
oni iwe awore mi o si tun pada si guest iwe to fi iwe to fun order developer iwe wo lo fun o kokko yo yen jade okan to wa ti won pe ni iwe eri pe ibi o afifun e ti awon ni guest pe ni allocation letter won tun gbo won ri pe o ba receipt mi iketa oni mo so be yin oni deed of assignment ti lawyer wo se seri tele la se awu fufun won nisin 110,000 ke tori te ki lawyer to se
tori e ti pe
e 110,000 fun lawyer ko fi se deed of assignment fun yin iyen ni eri to daju pe emi shop nbe
yi te wi ganisin o lo je ku ya pe ni ikilo o san ju eboruru tori eyin so ni se pe ni ile nku dede teyin o gbe kini ikale tijo ti o di tijoba ti o ba ti dipo di tijoba e cd da kun sadu mi
ko si nbe
o a ma ru eni ti won fi si in charge re gba won tan ba fun target pe ko lo gbo wa to si ti sawo pe o gba le o gba shop re o
ani eni ni oni shop
to o ni shop o
eyin na mo minister of enterprise
yes
ni manager abe
ah awon olowo de
o gba nkan won a ko gbogbo file a ko sodo won o tan
so e wi fun categorically pe ani se ko ni shop e so nkan meta yen le kan si
cherry nkan ta nso bi ni wi pe ni iloran trumode market eti gbogbo wa pe ni mandate market ti n bẹni adewole lori popona ọlọrun ṣogo ni wipe iwọ to o ba mọ ipo onisọ nbẹ to o ba wa ra iṣọ dakun gba iwe lọwọ o eti oyibo n pe ni receipt ikeji iwe ti wọn fi fi bẹ iṣọ yẹn fun wọn lamọ ni allocation letter jẹ ko wa lari to ọwọ rẹ o iketa òun ni deed of assignment tó o bá ti gba deed of assignment yẹ 10,000 wàá fi gba lọ́dọ̀ lọ́yà o
tọ ẹ ṣeun
so nǹkan mẹ́ta ó ṣe pàtàkì
bẹ́ẹ̀ ṣe sọ yìí ẹ wá bá mi sọ ní pidgin bẹ́ẹ̀ fáwọn àwọn yíbò wa ìbò fitifiti ẹ mọ
ẹ bá mi sọ
torí pé mo rí pé láwọn báńkì nínú bẹ́ẹ̀ náà ni
ẹ̀dọ́rọ̀ ikú ọmọ wà fi ní ìsinmi wa ní kí n bá sọ fíjì tó make I thank our oga o because na better work na he dey do as he talk am na true say make I use the pidgin talk because that our market Igbo dey there Hausa dey there for that our market people from south south this is them Calabar people they dey inside the market you hear me so and even our people for north central they full the market in short the market na dey they call Nigeria because na every tribe for Nigeria na dey there so as you say make I talk pidgin I thank you very much I thank you very much this your outfit God go put out
thank
you see we dey talk we say if you know say you dey our market you buy shop from us you no collect receipt I dey pity you we go not talk say MGM if you come I no go cook answer you no concern me if you don get allocation letter hey na another wahala o how you get shop when you don get allocation letter then the one wey come pay me pass there be say some people no even care to collect deed of assignment deed of assignment dey office wey dem no collect
they don't even pay for am
you don do am dem no come collect am you just do am there e go come collect your own o and if you know say you never collect abi your own no dey grand bring 10,000 make we give our lawyer make he do am sharp sharp wetin I use talk am be say look e remain small e remain just like 5 buildings wey we go do wey we go comot there and as we dey comot we go carry all the file everything down go give our ministry go give government e don finish be that o if you need the shop go meet the government if government give you you are lucky but I trust government if dem see say you no pay like somebody wey pay 100,000
since
2010
10 years ago
10 years ago Eh?
Was in the shop.
And they use the shop. They use the shop. And you, it's not even use their shop, let's say. And you not pay. So
they I love this. I think nobody we have excuse now that because they speak English or they speak about the speak. I think you have heard, please go and fulfill your own obligation. Yes. The shop, as much as they are interested in growing your business, in growing your creating wealth for you, please kindly fulfill your own obligation so that your future can be secured. We appreciate the managing director of a foremost developer in West Africa,
thank
that the Refit Construction and Engineering Company in Nigeria. Mr. Sidi, we so much appreciate your coming,
yes,
and
sir.
I'm sure everybody have heard your position,
yes,
and we appreciate your partnership with NAS TV Africa.
Thank you,
and we look forward to more mutual business benefit.
Amen.
And by the grace of God, we shall come again.
Thank
so
you.
This is where we call it a date today, and this is NAS TV Africa, where we manifest Africa's greatness. And on the screen, there's there are phone numbers that we're going to display. And after this program, please kindly look through all the numbers that you will see are the numbers that you are to call, and make sure you call them for every clarification, payment or allocation, and it is going to be well with all of us. Kindly subscribe to NAS TV Africa on our YouTube channel and follow us on our social media pages, Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. Till we meet next time, my name is Nasir Abdul Qadri, NAS TV Africa. We manifest Africa's greatness. Thank you.